And they took that spirit of adventure into their approach to this game. They're defending on occasion Cavalier. And who should take advantage but the debutant, Dom Dwyer.
And they were disjointed, Ghana was, in particular, just trying to deal with the high pressure. Viafania puts pressure. Paul Areola comes over, slides over. Okay, it's a lucky touch here from Viafania to find Dom Dwyer. But Dom Dwyer has led that pressure up front. He's been relentless. He's been a nuisance. And that's what you dream about in the opening game of your national team career, putting it away. Well, here was goal number two until the goalkeeper, Richard Ofori, comes off his line, studs up. That's a red card in my book. Dom Dwyer lucky he saw that last minute, gets out of the way. And then this is where Ghana got back in the game. I do think this is a penalty. I think Jorge Viafania has got Achimpong's jersey in his hand. He pulls him down. Slow walk up from Asamoah Gyan. Dragozan steps up to the challenge and makes a big save.
And of course, technically, to be even-handed, we've said that Richard Ofori should have been sent off for his scything challenge on Dwyer.
To make sure they can't get it right at Richard Ofori at that right post. But you would have to think the only real way here is to that right post hit with pace and hope for something to happen here.
It's Acosta. It's two. Very smoothly worked. And now Kellen Acosta takes his bow, having opened his international goal-scoring account.
And it's hard to argue, this is really the only way you can take this corner. But now the question is, for the Ghanaian keeper, Richard Ofori, when you put one, two, three, four, five, six, seven players in front of you, the one post you've got to take care of is right behind Dax McCarty. And that little thing, it's a little thing of Dax McCarty standing behind that wall. But Brad Guzan knows, any goalkeeper in the world, that is too quick to react. Well done from the United States, and a first goal from Kellen Acosta.
It comes on the occasion of his ninth cap. A 21-year-old Texan-born player, Japanese father. Important cog in the FC Dallas wheel in recent
honor now. Calling Achimpong against the United States in the Under-20 World Cup, I think, in 2013. He's been a real bright spot to this team. He's done well at Anderlecht. The one criticism has been he hasn't been as clinical in the final third that he needs to be. I remember during the Under-20s, Man City was looking at him and some bigger clubs like that. But today, he's been the one bright spot for Ghana in multiple positions.
A committee meeting which has just been called to a halt by Asamoah Gyan, who has heard an application for a colleague to take it and ignored it and taken it himself and scored, which in part makes up for the penalty failure. Asamoah Gyan scores his 51st international goal, the man who got the winner against the US in Rustenburg in 2010 on the mark again.
Well, and you can have an argument about Asamoah Gyan in his club career not scoring goals consistently, but what he's done in a Ghanaian national team jersey, 104 caps, 51 goals. And how many of those have been big, massive goals? That one of special quality from Asamoah Gyan.